One of my favorite parts of logging in the morning is this huge influx of money from all my sales. This is almost all a product of buy orders as well. I don't do much farming or resources myself. I'm dove into the markets in different settlements, moving materials all over, or setting up prices for components missing in different areas. I could tell you exactly what I do, but it changes day to day, and it's probably not the same on your server anyways. And honestly, I don't want to give up all my best tricks. Not yet anyways. What I can do is give you some principles to work off of so you can figure out what works on your server and be the first one to take advantage of some of these big gains. And all of these specific principles revolve around buy orders. Now, if you don't know what buy orders are, no big deal. It's pretty simple. In the market, you can put up money to buy items at a certain price. If someone has those items and likes the price you're offering, they can sell to you those items at the price you picked. So for example, I can go in, I can say I want to buy 100 steel ingots at $1. List this price, and if anybody wants to sell me their steel ingots at $1, this will fill and these will show up in my storage. Now the thing about buy orders is you're staying ahead of the swings in the market by taking advantage of people's urgency or fear. But don't sit on them too long because folks like to chase. And things that are a great profit one day can be a loss the next. So let's dive in and get you spooled up on how to make a ton of money. One of the easiest types of buy orders out there are items low-level players find that are worth a bunch of money, but they usually don't know. On my server, it was eggs for a long time. I'd put in a buy order for 1 or 2 gold for each egg, then turn around and sell the eggs for 20 or 40 gold each day. You can also do this with herbs in each specific town. So for example, I'll set buy orders for 50 cents for garlic in Everfall, peppercorn in Monarch's Bluff, mint in Windsward, and cinnamon in First Light. Then I'll collect all of them up every day and drag them to Everfall and sell them for 3, 4, sometimes 10 times what I paid for them. Now the next one is something I've been doing for a while now and has single-handedly helped me pay to level up some of my other crafting skills. This one can take a few days, but its payoffs are pretty huge. I'll set buy orders for about 20 cents for iron ore. Now this isn't Everfall, that's our main trade capital. Do this wherever your main trade capital is because that's where it's gonna be the cheapest. Now, when I say buy orders, I don't mean I'm buying 100 or 200. I'm buying 8,000 or 10,000 units of iron ore. I'll turn all of this into steel ingots. Now, the reason this makes so much money is the bonuses because of this. Just make sure you're using the higher tier fluxes. And that's the biggest reason you'll make so much money on this is the bonuses you get from using those higher fluxes. You just get so many free materials, it's ridiculous. The next key to this is selling the steel in several different cities where town boards are popular. So town boards are places where people can trade materials and a little bit of work for XP and town rep. It's honestly one of the quickest ways to power level in the game right now. So if you go to the cities where these are popular, you can often sell these materials for several gold per unit more than in your main trading hub. And they'll sell through almost every day. I built a little spreadsheet here to help you figure out some profits and costs with this steel specifically. Does the math for you so you can just type in a few numbers and know exactly where you need to buy and sell your steel at. The link is down in the description, so feel free to make a copy of it and edit to fit your economy. This spreadsheet is free for you to use. The only thing I ask is if you're using it and you're enjoying it, please hit like and maybe subscribe to the channel so you can get more resources like this from me and help this video out and push it to everybody else. Now keep in mind, this can apply to different materials on different servers. This can work for rawhide, fibers, and greenwood because they all have huge boosts in their quantities when you're manufacturing them. So check your server and work the items in that make the most sense for you. Now we'll build on this town board thing. They're another great way to make money with buy orders. I set buy orders on things like medium and large salmon, greenwood, wood louse, and many other items that are great to drag around to the active cities and sell at a good markup. In my server, I have my house in Everfall, my inn in Brightwood, and we have Azoth discounts for Faction in First Light, Cutlass, and Restless Shores. This makes moving around pretty cheap. So I'll drag around and sell a couple hundred steel, stacks of 500 greenwood, wood louse, salmon, sometimes potions, whatever I can drag around to each of these cities. One really important thing to remember though is to not get greedy. If you're crafting steel for 1.5 gold, it's selling in the trade capital for 2.5, but in Brightwood you see the lowest listing is 7. I've had so much better luck listing 200 or 300 steel for like 3.5 gold instead of listing it really high. Folks are much more willing to pay the prices for the town boards to complete then, and you'll turn your cash over much faster. This gives you the ability to use your money much more quickly and make even more money rather than sitting around for 3 or 4 days waiting for something to sell. This works on the inverse with buy orders as well. When I set 0.2 gold buy orders for iron ore, everyone else is usually setting 0.05 or 0.1, and those don't fill anywhere near as often or as fast as mine. So yes, I'm paying a little bit more, but my churn is much faster. All right, so hopefully this is helpful for you and you can make a bunch of money off of it. So get out there, start making a huge profit with your buy orders. As always, a quick shout out to the Patreons and a thank you to you just for watching the video all the way through. We'll see you in the next one.